Now I know it's been kind of controversial that I upgraded Paragon to 6 stars. We're actually on the way to getting all of his level up there as well, but I wanted to build out his masteries today to bring his true potential to the table. So that's exactly what we're going to be doing, because he's one of these guys that just does some magical things inside of the game when you're trying to kind of piece together some wins. So let's build these masteries. Before we do, make sure you download Raid Shadow Legends using my QR code or my link down below. It is not too late. Get involved right now. Get Rector Drath, one of my favorite Healer Reviver champions inside of the game. Another free champion and a whole bunch of goodies to progress your account. And sub the channel, boys, because we do this every day. All right, so for these masteries, we're gonna be focusing on both the offense and the defense trees. So let's get ourselves ready. All right, so starting with the offensive tree, we have to go and put some crit rate here, unlocking this one for plus 5% in the crit rate. Moving down to tier 2, we're gonna get some crit damage up by 10%, followed by Heart of Glory, increases damage inflicted by 5% when attacking with full HP. We're going with that as well. And then we're going straight down the line on the left, increasing damage inflicted to targets with less than 40% HP by 8%. We're gonna go over here with Bring It Down, increasing damage inflicted by 6% when attacking targets with higher max HP. Love that. Then we're gonna go with increasing the damage inflicted by this champion's default skill by 2% each time it's used during battle. Stacks across each round in a battle up to 10%. And then we're going down finally to War Master. Has a 60% chance of inflicting bonus damage when attacking. Bonus damage is equal to 10% of the target champion's max HP or 4% of the target's max HP when attacking bosses. Bonus damage can only occur once per skill and does not count as an extra hit. Unlocking that one as well. The offense tree is complete, and now we can move on to the defense tree. Now with the defense tree, we're starting out with Tough Skin. Defense plus 25 to begin. Next, we're moving to Blast Proof. Decreases damage received by AoE attacks by 5%. Loving it. Next, I wanna go with Resurgent. Has a 50% chance to remove one random debuff from this champion when they lose 25% of their max HP or more from a single enemy skill. We're gonna go right next door and go to Bloodthirst. Heals this champion by 10% of their max HP when they kill an enemy target, except bosses, minions. Cooldown, 1 turn. Super easy to choose that one. We're gonna delay death, reducing the damage this champion receives from a specific enemy by 0.75% with each hit taken from that enemy. Damage reduction stacks up to 6% for each enemy. Next door, we have a 60% chance of placing a leech debuff for 1 turn when placing stun, sleep, fear, true fear, freeze, petrification debuffs. Next, we're going with Cycle of Revenge. Has a 50% chance of increasing the turn meter by 15% when an ally is attacked with a critical hit. Will only increase the turn meter once if the ally receives multiple critical hits from a single skill. And then next door, we're going with the Skull Baby. Retribution has a 50% chance to counterattack when a champion loses 25% of their max HP or more from a single enemy skill. And what we have are our completed masteries. Now, how did I get them, I guess you're asking? Well, to get those masteries, all I did was I came in here and I ran a whole bunch of Minotaur. We used a bunch of energy, ran a bunch of Minotaur, got these masteries essentially for free because it was all passive energy. Again, extracting value from the game. Nothing crazy, but there's some things going on right now that we need to take a look at. First of all, Soul Merchant, anything in here? We should be doing some Iron Twins, because I'll tell you what, I could use that one right there. Tree Knot, we could use that one for sure. All right, but looks like we're a little bit late to that party. We do have the fusion going on as well right now, so it's worth noting that we are doing Dragon Tournament. We've progressed quite well. We're number 1, I think, in the tournament right now. Yes, we are 2nd. We're number 2 in the tournament right now. But we've also been doing Champion Training Tournament. We are in 3rd, 4th place. No, we're 5th place right now. We'll make our way up, though. We have a lot more grind to do with this champion training. We want to make sure that we get what we need to get. But again, we do have the time. The Dragon Tournament is what only has a little bit more time, but I did get what I needed to get. You want to see? There you have it. You know when I cross it out, it means that we have been successful. So I still have to finish this today. I have Dungeon Divers event, And I also have Champion Training Tournament that I have until Friday to complete. So that's a win-win. But we were looking at Paragon, and when we do look at Paragon, you'll notice that he has a bunch of gear that needs to be upgraded. Well, wouldn't that be funny? Because currently, there is an artifact enhancement event going on for this very fusion. So why not do it right now? We're gonna just double dip on events. We're gonna get all of these right now to level 60. We got almost 30 million silver, which is going to be a nice, easy upgrade progression. I saved the gear for this exact reason. I wanted to be able to use this in a smart time like right now. Now the question is, how far will these upgrades get me in that event? One of the pieces of gear was already 16, leaving us with only 5 pieces of primary gear and 2 pieces of secondary gear or accessories that we can actually get up to level. So let's see how that all turns out. I'm really curious. I'm expecting to go halfway through the artifact enhancement event with these upgrades. Let's see if I'm gonna be that lucky. So far, it has not even been that expensive. Look at this, we're still 22 million, which means we're about at 8 million spend. Let's see if we can get this banner up. I actually really liked this banner. It's quite a nice one. Now, let's take a look at where we are for the event. The gear, all leveled up. The skills, all leveled up. We need a blessing on Paragon, and his masteries are now complete. Let's take a look at what we have over here. I'm sure we got ourselves a bunch of energy that we can use to run in Dragon, and that's, oh baby, we are about halfway there. 2,370, and I need 4,700, that is literally halfway, wow. Okay, grab the energy, grab the charm, all this stuff, we're collecting it all, beautiful. Now, that's progress. Artifact enhancement, we could finish just by going in and fought, like, are there any champions that are just wearing level rank 12 gear? Like here, right here, what is this? Roshgard? Let's upgrade him up, let's get him up there, let's get him to 16. Why not? We need it for the event anyway. So I'm assuming since we made our way halfway there, we could probably get ourselves all the way, I think we will get all the way there if we do all this gear. This is the exact number of pieces of gear. We did 5, 7 pieces of gear before, and I think that this may actually be 6, so we're gonna be super close. And if you know, we had right here Roshgard. He was a big player and did some really nice things for us yesterday in the Doom Tower, because we're now progressing there as well. Yes, this isn't only a Masteries Tree guide. We go with the progression that happened on the account so you could see what it's like in real life. Because this is real life, baby. Raid Shadow Legends real life. All right, how far did that get us? I believe we're gonna be a little bit short. Let's see. We are a little bit short, another tome right there. We're short by about, okay, we could probably get one more piece of gear. Let's just finish this thing off right now because I wanna make sure that I don't have to, you know, worry about it. I don't wanna have to think about it. I don't wanna forget about it. Is there anyone that's wearing anything that's a level 12 or a level 15 because I was maybe holding on to it? I don't know. Everyone seems pretty leveled up right here. Let's do a deeper search. Looks like I found a pair of gauntlets that are on our girl right here, Vissix. We're just gonna upgrade these. We're gonna upgrade them all the way up to 16. Decent, I wouldn't mind speed. It didn't drop. Resistance and accuracy. Seriously, no luck on that one. And it wasn't enough for the event. We're still not there. What do we need? 45, we need one more. We need one more. I'm going back to Vissix and we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna find one more piece that she's maybe sitting on. What's a good one? The shield, accuracy, let's go with this one. We're gonna upgrade it all the way. I know, I would be really happy if we got speed, and we did. Speed, HP, accuracy, that should finish out the event. The artifact enhancement event, woo, is completed. All right, so it's your OCD boy Echo right here. Artifact enhancement number one completed, and then save. 2 of the 4 have been completed for the day. I could go into Dragon with a little bit of extra energy that we have right now and do some work against that dragon. What's going on in the clan over here? We gotta check in. Cool, and what's going on over here for quests? We got a little bit more quests done there as well. But we did not check what we did over in Clan Boss yesterday. We were able to do 3 runs, a brutal run. Let's see if we got anything from the brutal chest. Nothing good there. Anything good here? No, nothing good. Just a couple of gems, which I like them. All right, what do we got over here? Woo! 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 Legendary skill tome. That's why we do this. Give me another one. Oh my god, another one! 2 legendary skill tomes from the nightmare chest. and we even get ourselves an ancient shard. This is massive. Unbelievable. That wasn't even Ultra Nightmare. Let's see if Ultra Nightmare can compare. Let's see. I bet you it doesn't. Whoa! What? A sacred shard? What? Two legendary skill tomes and a sacred shard so far? What about this time? All right, and an ancient shard. What a good, good pull. We got some amazing pulls today. That's absolutely fantastic. I don't want to lose Wixwell in a nerf. Please, I need this for the progression of the account. That's going to be, I think that's 10 sacreds that we're sitting on right now, which could be really good for some of the events for this fusion. That's why we save them. Good, that was beautiful. And now we're just going to come on in and we're going to do the nightmare one. Remember back in the day? Back in the days when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore, but some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. I'm like your radio station here, guys. That's what we're doing right here. What do we get here for quest? We claim that one as well. I'll tell you what, we're gonna have to go in, and I wanna drop into this. No Odin's Trial, no Sand Devil, Dragon Tournament. We'll get this epic book up here, plus we're doing Dungeon Divers at the same time. Plus we're getting the champion training at the same time because, oh, that guy can come out. Let's actually come on over here and filter the reserve vault as well. And let's choose ourselves a nice, another Paragon? I actually have to save that Paragon. I need some 3 stars that we can use because we are very close to being able to upgrade another 6-star champion. I know, it's very exciting. So right now we're just gonna run this, smash this dragon, continue with the fusion, and now we have Paragon with his masteries, and I feel great about it. Now, we're having so much fun. Make this QR code so big that everyone has to download the game. Sub the channel, guys. I'll see you tomorrow.